everyone, welcome to another episode of Azure This Week. It's just me this week, and Ignite is over, but there's still plenty of news. Today we are talking new Azure infrastructure capabilities, Azure Trusted launch for virtual machines, new Azure Arc capabilities. There's plenty to cover, and before we start, I'd like to invite you to our brand new community hub on Discord. We'll be launching study hours, office hours to chat with the ACG team, and a way for you to connect with the ACG community, including myself. An invite to the server will be in the show notes of this episode. Let's dive into some Azure news. Azure has announced a couple of new infrastructure capabilities to improve the agility, scalability, and reliability of infrastructure deployed in Azure. These include new MSV2 machines enabling customers to achieve up to 20% increase in CPU performance and access up to 192 virtual CPUs and 4 terabytes of memory, available now in preview. Coming soon to preview, new Azure dedicated SKUs that let customers run a broader range of memory intensive workloads in a single tenant hardware isolated environment. Azure Spark Virtual Machines is getting a new feature that allows Azure to try and redeploy previously evicted spot VMs as part of a scale set. This would improve the overall runtime of scale out apps. VMware SD-WAN and the Azure Virtual WAN Hub integration is now in preview. So is Azure Route Server. Both of these services help users streamline operations between networking appliances and Azure's virtual network. New capabilities to manage Linux environments, yay for Linux, and the preview of Azure native integration with Elastic services, and much, much more. I know these features might sound a tad dry, but they are important. And it's great to see Azure putting in the work to improve the performance of the platform. For a complete list of all these new features, be sure to check out the link in the show notes and get all the details. Alrighty, let's move on to Azure Trusted Launch. Azure Trusted Launch is a new feature that is in preview now. It prevents bootkits and rootkit infections for virtual machines. These are types of malware that run with the same kernel mode privileges as the operating system they infect. So that means they can hide themselves from anti-malware, making them hard to detect and remove. So yeah, it's a pretty big deal. Trusted Launch leverages something called the Trusted Launch Virtual Platform Module, VTPM for short, to measure whether the boot of a VM has been compromised. You also get visibility into the integrity of the entire boot process. It's pretty simple to enable as well. You just need to make a slight change in your deployment code, or you can simply check a box off in the security section of the Azure portal. Azure Trusted Launch is in preview within select regions at no additional cost, and it supports the most commonly used operating systems with many more coming. Awesome. Time for some Azure Arc news. A big challenge to hybrid and multi-cloud adoption is managing and securing environments. And that's where Azure Arc comes in. Arc is a set of technologies that extends Azure management and services to any infrastructure, and Azure has announced updates that help it support even more scenarios. These include, you can now run Azure Machine Learning Service with Azure Arc. This means that you can extend machine learning capabilities to hybrid and multi-cloud environments, and you can train your models directly where your data lives. Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes is generally available. This will allow you to easily manage and govern Kubernetes clusters anywhere, right from your Azure portal. Azure has also collaborated with some of the popular Kubernetes distributions, including VMware Tanzu, Nutanix Carbon, which join already Red Hat, OpenShift, Canonical's Charmed Kubernetes, and Rancher Kubernetes Engine, RKE for short, to test and validate their implementations with Azure Arc. Back in our predictions episode, I did mention that Azure was going to be putting in a lot more work and focus on their Kubernetes support. So, I told you so. Overall, a great update for all of those Azure Arc users out there. Alrighty, that's it for this episode. Personally, I'm gonna give Trusted Launch a try later today. I think it's a really neat feature. Let me know what you think about it in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date with all the cloud news. Keep being awesome, cloud gurus. I'll see you in the next one.